Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. To kick off this video, just a reminder that we have two launches coming up for this second half of the week. As you can see on the SpaceX fans website, we can expect the launch of the CSG2 mission tomorrow, Thursday 27th at 11:11 PM UTC or 6:15 PM Eastern Time. In addition to the launch tomorrow, there is yet another launch scheduled for just a couple of days later. Again, as you can see on the SpaceX fans website, the launch of Starlink Group 4-7 is expected to lift off on Saturday 29th at 8 PM UTC or 3 PM Eastern Time. SpaceX posted a tweet on Monday about the return of their most recent Cargo Dragon capsule from the ISS. They said, "Splashdown of Dragon confirmed, completing SpaceX's 24th resupply mission to the space station." After that, they also posted saying, "Once Dragon has been retrieved by SpaceX's recovery team, the critical science aboard the spacecraft will be transported by helicopter to Kennedy Space Center and provided to researchers." There was an interesting article posted by Ars Technica. It says SpaceX launched its first interplanetary mission nearly 7 years ago. After delivering the payload, the Falcon 9 rocket's second stage was high enough that it did not have enough fuel to return to Earth's atmosphere. It also lacked the energy to escape the gravity of the Earth-Moon system, so it has been following a somewhat chaotic orbit since February 2015. Now, according to Sky Observers, the spent second stage's orbit is on course to intersect with the Moon. Marcus House posted a tweet to Elon Musk related to Starlink and how the satellites would work on Starship. He said, "Do you have any information on how the cargo, such as blocks of Starlink V2 satellites, will be loaded into the Starship? Really interesting seeing the cargo door prototype at Boca right now. If door swings down, that would make it a tad harder to load cargo into it, I assume." Musk responded with, "This is a matter of much internal debate." Heading over to Boca Chica, here's a view of the orbital launch mount continuing to be worked on. Work is also continuing on Mechazilla's chopstick catching arms. Lots of work on the Mechazilla launch and catch tower has been continuing too. Parts of the suborbital launch pad area have been dug up. Here's a view of the rapidly progressing wide bay in the production yard. There are a bunch of Starship and Super Heavy domes waiting to be sleeved in the yard. This interesting tank structure has been spotted in one of the fabrication tents. I wanted to share an article from NASA Spaceflight on Raptor 2 testing, as I've seen a load of videos of Raptor 2 tests recently. The article says numerous Raptor 2 engines are now being put through their paces at SpaceX's test center in McGregor, involving static fire testing at the 5 test bays ahead of the evolved engine being shipped to Starbase to be involved in future launches. After being taken off of suborbital pad B, Starship 20 was moved over to near the orbital launch mount. Here's a view of the Starship 22 thrust section sitting in the mid bay. The B2.1 test tank was recently hooked up to a crane to be lifted. Then, the B2.1 test tank was lifted off of the structural test stand. Here's a view of the aero covers and quick disconnect interface on Super Heavy Booster 4. Taking a look at the road and beach closures on the Cameron County website, the closures for the start of this week were cancelled. There was also a closure scheduled for tomorrow before it was cancelled during the day. So, at present, the only road and beach closure scheduled is Friday 28th. Here's a cool view of a robotic welder working on Super Heavy Booster 7's final methane tank section. As always, I have to say thanks to Mary, known as Boca Chica Girl, for being out there filming the Starbase content. As well, thank you to Nick Antsuini for being out there filming some of the Starbase content in this video too. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.